All right, maybe actor and filmmaker Christopher Gorham is more honest than I am. I was talking about how melancholy I am that school has started and the kids are back. Three kids at school. What's your feeling?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Let them go.
Go to school.
See? No tears there. Augie in Covert Affairs. You've worked a ton.
Thank you.
Has it been the way you wanted it to go? I mean, you work all the time.
Yeah, I mean, so far, you know? Yeah, I mean, it's just, look, you talk to actors all the time. We have so little control over how our career goes, so you kind of treat every job like it's the last and do the best job you can and try to be nice to people and hope they invite you back.
There you go. You met your wife on Popular.
We met at UCLA, actually, before Popular,
okay.
But we worked together on Popular, yeah.
And so, when did romance, because we're now going to show the cute family photos and stuff.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Did romance bloom on the set of Popular or UCLA? Or what?
Oh, no, we were already engaged, I think, when we started Popular.
Oh, okay. Ah.
Wow. No, I was very serious about locking that up.
All right, so how does one go about locking it up?
Listen, you romance, you be nice, you get some gifts, right? Take them out to dinner.
Old school.
Old school.
You've been raised properly.
Right.
Thank you.
It so rarely happens. A new movie now we're going to talk about, A Boy Called Poe. And in the film, you're a single dad. You know, they talk with autism about this quote-unquote autism spectrum.
Correct.
And Poe here seems less high-functioning.
Yeah. He's kind of, I guess you would say, kind of your middle of the range child with autism. Mm-hmm. He is verbal. He does have some pretty remarkable skills, but socially very, very awkward, very shy. Emotionally has a really hard time knowing what's going on and being able to, more importantly, being able to express what's going on inside.
Did you come to learn a lot more about autism?
Yeah, well, my oldest son is actually on the spectrum. So I came in already having learned quite a bit. But the character in the film is very different from my son. But the nice thing about this movie is almost everyone that was involved with the film has a direct attachment to families with autism. They either have a son with autism or a nephew or... really, everybody was familiar with it and really wanted to get it right.
Do you get the sense there is more of it, or my thought is there's more diagnosis of it now?
Yeah, I think that's a huge part of it. I think that the recognizing what the autism spectrum disorder is has allowed more people to be diagnosed with it. I think, you know, 20, 30 years ago, some of these kids were written off as lots of inappropriate names. But now we know what's going on. We know things that can help them. We still don't know really what causes it. It's been interesting because in the case of my son, we actually do know the cause because he was diagnosed with this rare genetic disorder called 22q deletion. Hmm. It's about as common as Down syndrome. No one's ever heard of it. Hmm. But one of the symptoms of that is autism. Hmm. But for most families who have children with autism, they don't know. I think the important thing about the message of this movie is it's nothing to be afraid of. Don't be afraid of these kids. Love them, accept them. They have gifts and joy and love that they want to give to you.
I tell you what, this can best be described as a somewhat heroic scene. The son has caused some trouble at a mall. Watch this.
You'll need to make restitution for the damaged items. It's going to be a few $1,000s. So.
Oh, you got to be kidding me.
We have your name and address. She'll be sending you the bill.
Okay. Thank you. I'm so sorry about this. I'll take care of all this. Thank you for your help. Come on, let's go.
Come on, sir. A few words of advice, if I may.
Okay.
If I was you, I'd keep my retarded kid on a leash. That way he won't get away from you.
Time to go, Poe.
My dad's a wrestler.
Yeah.
How good did it feel to throw that punch?
It's good, man. I tell you, that's like as a parent of a kid on the spectrum, you definitely have those moments where that's exactly what you'd like to do.
Mm. You making movies as well. This film, We Love You, Sally Carmichael's got really good notices.
Yeah, thank you. It's my feature directorial debut. It's a really sweet, totally family-friendly comedy. It's in theaters in Utah right now, and it'll be everywhere on DVD and video soon.
There you go. It's all going your way.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, Boy Called Poe hits select theaters nationwide tomorrow. Also available on a variety of digital platforms as well. Christopher, nice to meet you this morning.
Hey, thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, everybody.